We are talking to Executive Vice President Jinder Talwar. So, Jinder, tell me, being this, you know, accepting this new position as Executive Vice President of WIFA, how you are going to help Indian community, particularly the women in general?
First of all, I would like to say thank you for making me a part of this beautiful organization. And I feel very honored and proud to be a part of Women's Federation of Indo-Americans. Like we have came to this country like 24 years ago, and we have some hardship, hard time and struggles which we have gone through. And now the things have changed, and a lot more to offer. Even beside all that, we feel that there are a lot of issues and problems in each individual or the, in the community, which people need a lot of help. So we will offer our services to them, so that in any area, like I've been helping, doing my volunteering work in teaching children like music and helping kids to become a better Indian citizen, you know, of India and America. So I render my services to them to make them a better citizen or any area whichever I can help them. I will try to do that my best.
So Anila and Jinder, will you be please telling me what kind of problem the Indian women are generally facing in this community?
Major issue which we see is here is the woman has lots of problem at home, domestic violence, ignorance, and job placement kind of things, job placement. So we are going to try to help women, guide them, direct them, whichever way we can help them. We have networking system developed, which I mentioned earlier. So whatever the kind of issue they have, we'll go from there.
So Jindi, you have been dealing with a lot of Indian kids for like last 24 years. So tell me, what is will be your plan to bring them into the Indian culture, the mainstream of Indian culture?
Like a lot of kids and the moms, they don't have actually that much time because we want our children to be raised in India and living in America. And our kids and the women, they struggle more because we want them to be an Indian and learn all the Indian events and the cultures and also Americans. So they go through a lot and they don't have that much time. The moms are busy, they have to work, they have to cook food and and then we will...
Now tell me one more important thing. I mean, as being a part of your experience in United States, what will be your suggestion to the new Indian women who are coming, you know, fresh from India and feeling loss of support that they're accustomed to Indian environment?
All the new Indian immigrants, I will suggest that there are a lot of organizations, a lot of like temples and the gurdwaras. They should be a part of that. They should be in touch and they should go out and ask for help. You know, there are a lot of organizations they're supporting. Because when we came to this country, there were hardly any gurdwaras and they were only open once a week. And now I see there are like 20 gurdwaras or temples and organizations in LA or area only. And they're like offering their services every day. So, and also they should be in touch with those organizations and ask the help if they need any, because there's a lot of help offered like this organization. Women Federation of Indo-Americans is one of that, will be offering their services to help them in any field. If there's any kind of children problem or there's like a violation problem in the domestic violation, they should not keep the things in themselves, but they should let it out so that somebody can guide them. You know, this is what is all about this organization. So if anybody else needs help, so we are there to help.
Okay, so Jindi, my question was very specific for the Indian young moms, you know, the kind of problem they face. So tell me specifically, I mean, having gone through that experience, when you are young mom, you know, having the young kids, what will be, you know, how you are going to support those young moms who are having the young kids and not getting the support from their grandparent?
It's a very good question, actually. I think it's a very blessing to have grandparents, which we unfortunately we all don't have that opportunity of having the grandparents with us. And even if we have them, you know, they are still dependent on us according to the laws and regulations of this country. And we can definitely arrange some kind of services for them, like to pick up their kids or taking them to events and giving them carpool services, you know, so that they are not stayed behind. If the mom is working, we can offer them that. We can pick up your kids if you are going to the temple or Gurdwara, if there's any community service or like any Diwali Mela. So we can all support each other, you know, so they can not be deprived from all these events.
That's very good. So Anil, I have another question. Like, there's a lot of women who come from India who doesn't know, you know, they're lacking in English communication skill, or they're lacking in professional skill to be adapted to the American society. So how your organization is going to provide a platform for them to, let's say, learn, you know, better communicative English, or let's say to get them trained professionally so that they can go out and find a job?
Back 20 years ago or 30 years ago, we didn't have that kind of opportunities here. Now we have lots of skill centers, English learning classes from the community schools like a Cal Poly or Mount Sinai, kind of where people can register only for like a $5 or $10 per session. We can guide them to take them. We can meet, do the events with a group where people can bring their issues, and we can discuss, and then together we can go from there how we're going to help them.
Even there are some like adult schools which we can make them aware of that. Free services are rendered,
Okay, so as a concluding remark, both to Anil and to Jindi, so tell me, how do you see your organization 2 years or 3 years from now? How it is be serving this community?
I know this question, where we're going to reach depends also, but we are determined to make a difference.
So do you also feel that this organization is going to make a solid difference in the community?
Yeah, with everybody's help, you know, among depends all the members, they all work hard, and I think it can succeed very well.
Okay, thank you.
We can make a difference in the community and with our help and support.
We going to do the services dedicatedly, selflessly, and whenever something is done for the good cause, selflessly, and it comes from a heart and soul, I know even few people can make a difference.
Thank you.